I don't really talk much about Linux Mint, but there is one topic that comes up from time to time. Mint, GNOME apps, and LibidWaiter. GNOME applications look perfectly fine, perfectly consistent within the GNOME environment, or something designed to also kinda look and kinda feel like the GNOME environment. And that's basically it. Anything else, they stick out like a sore thumb. A lot more than traditional GTK apps, a lot more than KDE apps, a lot more than just regular things built with Qt, and that's without even taking theming into account. If you do that as well, obviously there are going to be UX design differences and things like that. They're made for different environments, but most people care about colors and button shapes. And once you've solved that issue, yeah, it's not going to be perfect, but it's going to look a lot nicer than taking a LibidWaiter app and shucking it just on KDE. And a while back, Mint and Cinnamon, the desktop used on Mint, really started to notice this problem and went so far as reverting applications back to their older GTK3 versions just as a way to make them fit more in the environment. Yes, they were gonna have less features, but at least they looked like they were part of the environment. And with Cinnamon, this is especially true because it's an intentionally older looking design. It is a traditional, classic desktop experience inspired by things like Windows Vista, Windows 7, and take a LibidWaiter app and put it on that environment. Doesn't even look like you're running it on your system. And recently, Clem, the maintainer of Mint, had more to say on this topic in the recent monthly news. Here is the main thing I wanted to make the video about. LibAdWaiter. I wonder what Whisper is going to write that as. Usually it's LibAdWaiter, like it says on the board. I wonder how many of those I'm gonna have to fix. Anyway, a year ago, we complained about LibAdWaiter not because it was bad, but because it didn't support us. Applications made with this library only properly integrated with GNOME and broke functionality in Cinnamon, Mate, and XFCE. Also in KDE. The point where you grab these applications, if you want to resize them, is... it's a little bit flaky. Now, if you do the whole thing of super and move, you never notice the issue. If you do super resize, never notice the issue. But if you want to use the corners of an application, the definition of corner is a bit weird. So with the release of Linux Mint 22, GNOME apps which use LibidWaiter were downgraded back to their GTK3 versions so that they continue to function properly in the desktop environments we support. This was a temporary solution until these applications either got replaced, removed, forked, or until we found a way to continue using them. And I remember there being a very serious discussion about forking GTK3. Now, forks already do exist, obviously. Everything open source has a fork, but I mean an actual serious fork that directs into basically a new toolkit line. That never really went anywhere because just Mint by itself wouldn't make any sense, or just Cinnamon by itself wouldn't make any sense. You'd have to get the others like XFCE on board, like Mate on board. If that happened, that would be a very interesting timeline to be in. Right now, though, that's not really happening. There is something known as the XApp Initiative, and this has been around for a while. This is about building traditional GTK applications that aren't Cinnamon applications, that aren't Mate applications. These are generic GTK applications that can fit into any of these environments with the goal of being themed, with the goal of fitting in to whatever environment you're talking about. As you can see, there are applications here, but there's nowhere near enough to build a full desktop environment around. So right now you still have each of these desktops building their own tools, and I do think that if this was something they all came together to work on, this would be an incredibly valuable resource that I feel like would allow more desktop to exist in general, as they don't have to focus on building the things that everyone is going to have anyway. I know our audience isn't ready to let theming die. It would be extremely unpopular right now if we were to remove the theme selection. And since we provide it, it has to work. We cannot ship with a desktop that provides a theme selection and a core set of applications which violate it. As shown above, we've updated Minty to use the same colors as LibidWaiter. We also made the LibidWaiter accent color follow the theme. This helps the integration, but it's only a small step towards properly integrating the applications. It doesn't solve the issue with window controls and doesn't help with other themes. So they can make it so one of their themes aligns with LibidWaiter, but that's just one of the themes. And as I was saying before, people do care about buttons. Buttons are going to stick out very strongly. Colors are going to stick out very strongly. Most other things, you can get over it. Whilst I don't like a lot of these choices GNOME has made, I do respect the fact that they have made them. GNOME is not a desktop for everyone. It is a very curated experience. It's a very specific kind of design, and that is what they want. They don't want you heavily theming things. They'll provide you accent colors because accent colors are very nice and accessibility thing as well, but they don't want to have this whole you can change everything with CSS, and understandably so. I just wish that vision was more properly communicated, because I think the reason why so many people dislike what's going on is there is a mismatch of expectations and the reality. If from the get-go it was, hey, we're gonna provide a thing which does this, and this is the only way we talk about it, I don't think anybody, sure, people would complain, but I don't think you'd have the same level of complaint. I think the issue comes from the idea that there is this talk of GNOME being for everyone, GNOME being the universal environment, but it doesn't actually do that. Whether we downgrade or fork applications, I know many of the GNOME developers are as sad as we are about this fragmentation and duplication of efforts. I think everybody in a sense is kind of sad about that, not just in that case, but the idea of X applications as well. The idea that every desktop has a media player, every desktop has an image viewer, every desktop has a text editor, every desktop has this and that. There was a time where every desktop had a browser. I'm so happy that's been thrown to the wind, because that's a giant waste of effort, and a browser is a project unto itself that could take up the entire time of working on a desktop. I would like a world where there was more shared effort if the idea is you're using the same toolkit. I know it's never gonna happen, right? It is absolutely never gonna happen, but a part of me wishes that happened. A part of me wishes this was the world we were in. We were talking about extracting EPUB support in XReader last week and making a new app. It will take between a week and a month to achieve the level of functionality we see in something like Folate, but what's the point long term? Wouldn't it be better for Folate to work outside of GNOME and for us to use it? Within our XApp discussions, we talk about Qt, GTK3 applications, application alternatives, forks and rewrites. What we looked at recently is slightly different. How do we make GNOME apps continue to work outside of GNOME, doing the very thing that GNOME people really don't want you to do? Is there anything actually wrong with them once they follow the theme and provide proper window controls? We gave it a try. We added LibidWaiter style sheets in MintX and MintY, or Minty, however you want to say it, and made a few changes in LibidWaiter to not use its own style sheet. And it looks surprisingly consistent. It's not perfect. Absolutely is not perfect. Nothing is going to be perfect here. It is different UX design, but it's as close as you're gonna get. As you can see, the layout and style of LibidWaiter widgets is different than in traditional GTK3 applications. It's more touch-friendly with side panes, split navigation header bars, rather than menu bars and toolbars. I will disagree on this point. I think they intend to be more touch-friendly. But having actually used GNOME applications on a phone, on a small-scale touch device, I think the best way to describe it is they are desktop applications that emulate mobile applications. It's this, like, kind of looking like mobile applications, but as soon as you try to use it in that context, you realize that there's very little testing on that side. Having used regular old KDE Plasma on a Steam Deck, not even Plasma Mobile, I would argue even Plasma Desktop feels more mobile friendly, feels more touch friendly than the way GNOME currently works. In the GIF above, GNOME Calendar, GNOME Characters, and Folate are Libidwaiter applications, and they integrate well. He says really well. I would say well enough where it's not going to annoy me, and the theme selector is actually working. If we apply these patches to Libidwaiter, obviously downstream in the Mint project, not in Libidwaiter itself, because they definitely don't want anything to do with these patches, we probably won't need to continue to downgrade the GNOME applications. Upstream and long term, if we continue to use Libidwaiter applications, we probably need an XApp platform lib similar to Libidwaiter, either in the form of a soft fork, libs and or apps which are often released on upstream, or in the form of an extension library, something that extends Libidwaiter similar to LibGranite. LibGranite, if you don't know, is from the Elementary OS project. New day, new shirt. Turns out that is exactly what is being done. Here we have LibAdapter. This was started by Clem of the Mint project, and this is a soft fork of Libidwaiter. This is Libidwaiter with theme support and a few extras. It provides the same features and same look as Libidwaiter by default, so if no theming is being done, it's gonna look like Libidwaiter already does. In desktop environments which provide theme selection, LibAdapter apps follow the theme and use the proper window controls. Now, are other distros going to adopt this? I think it is possible that the ones that want to have very custom sort of looks to them may at least consider it. And this is a soft fork. It can be rebased onto new versions. Effectively, it is a patch set on top of Libidwaiter. It only intends to add features, not deviate long term. The goal isn't to create a new way to make applications, it's to take existing Libidwaiter applications and then make them themeable. So why do this instead of go to Libidwaiter directly? Well, as I said earlier, Libidwaiter is a GNOME only platform. It will not support theming or desktop features which are not present in GNOME. Libidwaiter has the right to be what it wants to be and to not support what it doesn't want to support. How do we know that high level theming is not going to be a thing that exists in Libidwaiter? Well, the whole stop theming my apps thing, this was a GNOME led initiative. A lot of people involved in GNOME do not want people theming their applications at a distro level. Users, individuals, doesn't really matter, but distros as a whole, they want nothing to do with it. Now, they could have made it an extension to Libidwaiter rather than a soft fork, and this is something that was discussed with the Libidwaiter team and was rejected. LibGranite support in Libidwaiter, which is an extension to the platform, could also disappear since this is something the Libidwaiter team does not like. Now, as for how theming works, this is based on the GTK3 model. Now, being something made for Mint, it very likely works for the Mint theme, and considering how new this is, there's probably going to be problems with themes that don't come from Mint. So, with this being really new, it was sent to me about 10 hours ago and this basically just happened. Do expect to see bugs, but I'm very curious to see where this is going to go. I think the main issue that exists here isn't the fact that Libidwaiter exists and there are GNOME applications built with Libidwaiter. If that was the case, yeah, it'd be annoying for desktops like Simon, which make use of GNOME applications, but they could very easily replace them. I think the main issue that exists is that a lot of applications outside of the GNOME ecosystem are being built with Libidwaiter as well, and you will run into applications that you really like, and then realize the toolkit they're built with, and you're like, ah, I have to deal with the problems of this toolkit, don't I? I am very curious to see what happens with this side project by Mint, with this side project by Cinnamon, and whether we're going to see a similar thing happen from the other GTK-based desktops as well, or if they're just going to build all of their own things, and really the way this is going to pan out. Because Libidwaiter isn't going anywhere, and if there's going to be desktops built off of the GNOME ecosystem, it is a problem they will have to address. This is why Cosmic exists, by the way, because the Cosmic team, the System76 team, just wanted something they could actually control, and they could really decide, these are features we want on the desktop, not just build an extension that every other version is going to break. But what do you think Mint should do about these GNOME applications and these general Libidwaiter applications? Should it even be a concern? Do you actually care about theming? I would love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. If you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to Liberapay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and you've seen my desktop. You know how I feel about theming.